I know you miss me. Who is gonna be if it ain't me, you, baby? Me, you city. Cause I need it one more time. Might lose it all, I swear. I need it tonight. How we get so deep so fast? Hey, stop playing, I beat your ass. You be on some toxic shit, but how can I get off this bitch? I haven't seen you in 3 months, I miss you, can I see you, babe? Every time I see one of your pictures, that shit drive me crazy. Girl, I know you miss a nigga, especially how I kiss it. Message say deliver, why the fuck you keep going missing on me? Every time you get back in the picture, you act different on me. Hey, tell that nigga that we gon' have to share it. I ain't trippin' on it. One more time might be the best for both of us. Maybe we should talk about it later when we sober up. Maybe we should keep it going. Maybe we should let it go. Feel like every minute is what it is, so I just let it flow. Got something to handle, so I'ma be here for a couple hours. Figured out you like to my assistant, keep on sending flowers. They got their own business, tell me why the fuck they all in the house. Mama raised a lot of things, but she ain't raised no fucking cow. We went to the moon last time, I'm tryna go back.
Man.
As hell, damn car.
Check this out, y'all.
Man.
So, topic of the day. So, how to change your habits that are keeping you in the cycle that you're in constantly. One thing that comes to mind to me is awareness. Roll the windows up one second. Holy cow. But one thing that comes to mind is awareness, because again, you'll hear me beat routine probably. Routine's gonna have a huge part, but so you have to be aware of what's going on in order to make changes. If you're not aware, then it's gonna be really hard to make adjustments. You know, being able to even have an intention behind your adjustment as well. If I don't know that I have something going on or something exactly wrong, it's going to be hard to intentionally make that adjustment or intentionally change that habit. So first step is awareness. You need to have awareness. And to even have awareness, it's getting rid of distractions, right? We live in a world full of social media, and social media is a great thing. It's just, it's how you perceive things. And if your perspective is warped or it's in a bad place, then you're not going to see anything except the negative sides of everything. So, but when you're vibrating higher, you're in a higher place or a higher mood, you're going to see nothing but all the positives. You know, I look on posts now because I get myself prepped and ready, and I don't see anything negative anymore on social media. So it's like everything is... You can utilize everything. It can be the downfall of you, or it can be the come up for you. So take that into consideration. And that's something that's huge. It's played a huge role in my big step that helped me out to get to that point was sometimes taking off social media for and just grounding yourself or getting yourself in a spot where you can begin that process of growth. Maybe you don't have to bounce off it. I recommend it though, because if the more distractions I can get rid of, the more that I'll hear what I need to hear. You'll trust intuition, you'll trust all these things that you don't trust because you're so distracted with social media and with worrying about what that person's doing, what this person's doing. As soon as you get rid of certain things, you're going to center yourself and you will have nothing. Your brain's going to freak out because that's where your energy is going to go. And you'll be surprised how much focus you have, how much intention behind it you have, and how much feeling and how much at peace you are just because your energy is not scrambled everywhere. You're genuinely going to be more happy. Just from start, just because you're like, holy cow, like now I can actually, I feel good. You're just going to feel good. It's going to feel natural. It's like it should. Perspectives that create a negative or a positive energy. And that's going to be the game changer to anything. Bottom line, people want to know how people get to the top or how people get to certain areas of life. And it's like, that's how it happens. You don't get there by accident. So it's all about becoming aware, you know, making those adjustments. And then taking one step at a time, because we're all such in a rush to get to where we need to be. And it's like, you guys rush, trip, fall, then you have to turn around, take a step back. And it's like, if you just took one step at a time every single day and just got base hits, you know, you wouldn't even have to worry about it. Be where you need to be, right? If you couple that with consistency, one step at a time a day, have some short-term goals too as well, but just look at the long view and just take one step at a time. Dude, you're going to be exactly where you need to be and where you want to be. Where you want to be. I'd say where you want to be, because you want to get to the point where you don't need things. You don't want to need it. I just want to want things. I think it's okay to want things. There's nothing wrong with that. When you get to needing things, it becomes a starving. You don't want to starve. You just want to be hungry. There's a difference between starving and being hungry. I want to be hungry for something, right? When I'm starving, you're going to do anything you can to stab people in the back. You're not giving off what you should be getting in return. You're going to give out what you get in return, so you're not giving off the right energy. And just branching off awareness, the first step to being able to change habits. If I'm aware, then we're going to be in business. We're going to be making adjustments. We're going to be climbing ladders. We're going to be able to get down to the bottom of things. There's not a better feeling. I equate it all the time to baseball. Like, if I can't feel a certain movement when I'm swinging or throwing, it's really hard to make that adjustment. And it's almost like insanity in a sense. But as soon as you know that, oh crap, I did this, I need to do this, it's easy to make that adjustment move. And then the second part of just changing habits is taking action. Now I have to take action, because action is going to be the coordinator of how I feel. If I don't take action, I'm going to feel like shit. As soon as my mind knows that there's something I want, it's in here, it's in my mind, I can't unsee it or unvisualize it. I have to get it. I have to find a way to get it. That way I can get back to my purpose, which is giving back. I have to find a way to get it.
Yeah. Damn. Let's take them back.
Oh shit, I'm gonna stop something.
Uh-huh. Coming up, I was confused. My mommy kissing a girl. Confusion occurs coming up in the cold world. Daddy ain't around, probably out committing felonies. My favorite rapper used to sing, check out my melody. I wanna live good, so shit, I sell dope for a four finger ring. One of them gold ropes. Nana told me if I pass, I get a sheepskin coat. If I can move a few packs, I get the hat. Now that'd be dope. Tossed and turned in my sleep that night. Woke up the next morning, niggas that stole my bike. Different day, same shit, ain't nothing good. In the hood, I run away from this bitch and never come back if I could. Needed a love it, the underdog's on top. And I'm gon' shine, homie, until my heart stop.
Go ahead, envy me, I'm Raps MVP. And I ain't going nowhere, so you can get to know me.
Needed a love it, the underdog's on top. And I'm gon' shine, homie, until my heart stop.
Go ahead, envy me.